Miss Malaika is proudly brought to you by Infinix Mobility, Kenya Airways,
Dark and Lovely, Maybelline,
GTP, Tomrick Hotel, GH1 TV.
Malaika, 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 Malaika.
And welcome to Miss Malaika Ghana 2019. It's the final eviction episode, and after many weeks of grooming sessions and different tasks, it's time to find out which of our delegates will get a spot in our top 10 and will make it to the grand finale, which, by the way, is happening on the 2nd of November at the National Theatre. Before I even give you more information, let me introduce my ladies to you one more time. As it stands, we have 14 delegates, and by the end of this episode, four of them will have to kiss the competition goodbye. My name is Berle Mundi, and again, you're welcome to Miss Malaika Ghana. Here we come, ladies. You can join me. And yes, they're coming with their bag and baggage, because tonight, when you get evicted, you're going home, unfortunately. And there you have it, our 14 beautiful and, of course, talented and intelligent delegates. And they join me at this point. Good evening, ladies. How are you doing? I know you're tired. It's been a long day, but it's been good in general, right?
Yes.
Let me ask one of you. Sophie, let me ask you first. Do you remember the first time that you came to audition for Miss Malaika? And did you think you were going to make it this far?
Yes, I do remember. I wasn't sure if I was going to make it. Mm. I was really nervous that day.
Yeah.
But it actually went well.
And here you are today.
Yes.
And who knows if you just might even make it to the top 10. We wait to find out. Phyllis, I remember when I called you on phone to break the news to you that you had made it. But before that, I told you that you had not made it. And you gave me a very funny reaction. I don't know if you weren't sure.
Yes, I wasn't really sure.
So what if I try that on you this time around? Would you believe me? You don't want that at all.
No, not at all. But what have you learned
all throughout the competition?
Oh, I've really learned a lot. I've learned to be more confident,
yeah,
more outspoken. I've learned how to relate very well with people.
Mm.
Yes, I would say I've learned a lot.
I love the woman I'm becoming. Okay, where's
Gisella?
Okay, let me ask you this. The woman you were before you joined Miss Malaika and the woman that you are now, do you think that there's been a difference?
Yes, a very huge difference.
Tell
between
me.
Then and now.
Okay.
Because I'm much more confident now.
Mm.
Before, I used to be so nervous and little things used to scare me, but
yeah,
now I'm more outspoken.
Yeah.
Yes, and as she said, I can relate well with people now.
Exactly.
Because
nothing
before,
scares
I wasn't
you
like
anymore.
That. Yes.
Not even eviction, right? So you see? Well, yes, eviction always, always makes you feel the jitters. But regardless, I want you all to remember that even to have made it this far is a plus out of over 100 of ladies who auditioned for Miss Malaika Ghana. And so take out the good parts and be a better person as you move forward, okay? But to the top 10, all the best to you. And again, we've been talking about voting, voting, voting. This is when it matters the most, because if you did not vote for your favorite, then unfortunately, she's going to have to say goodbye to the other delegates and watch them as they mount the stage at the grand finale, which, by the way, again, is happening on the 2nd of November at the National Theatre. Tickets are selling for 100 Ghana cedis, so make sure you buy yours. Come cheer your favorite girl and remember to continue voting. And on that night, aside from seeing this bevy of beauty, we'll also have some great performances from Adina, Kelvin Boyd, Dope Nation and Medical. And so you don't want to miss this for anything in the world. Anyway, you're still watching Miss Malaika Ghana 2019. It's the final eviction episode. And right after that, they are going on tour across the country. So keep watching. We'll keep you updated when we get back.
Arabic, bro, Arabic, bro, Arabic, bro, Arabic,
Join us at the National Theatre on the 2nd of November. Tickets are going for 100 Ghana cedis. See you there!
Some people believe this generation is self-obsessed because of our love for selfies and how we take pictures of everything. But we know better. We know that a selfie is how you capture and celebrate your journey. If you come across something exciting, take a second to capture it. Record it. Show the world. And you'll never know. It might just be the beginning of something great. That's why we have made the Infinix S4. Infinix S4 with a 32 megapixel AI selfie camera. Empower the Infinity U.
Africa, it's amazing and it's ours. So why not get out there and explore it with Kenya Airways? We crisscross this incredible continent over 500 times a week, offering unrivaled connections to over 40 destinations via our world-class hub in Nairobi. There's so much more to see. Discover Africa with Kenya Airways, the pride of Africa.
Find. Special thanks to Nasco from Electroland, Holy Trinity Spa and Farms, Belacqua,
Jumia Food and Jumia Travel,
Perga Transport, Afrisoko Online, Copan Hospitality, Omani Beauty, City Escape Hotels, delicious meals served to our delegates by Urban Taste, Eddie's Pizza, Cockpit Bar and Lounge, Starter Pack, Sam's Bite, Carbo Corso, Piano Bar, Fruit Kinke.
Welcome back. It's still Miss Malaika Ghana 2019, the final eviction episode. And just a reminder, the grand finale is slated for the 2nd of November at the National Theatre. Tickets are going for 100 Ghana cedis. And of course, aside enjoying the performances from our ladies, we'll also have some musical performances from Medical, Dope Nation, Kelvin Boy, and of course, Adina. And you don't want to miss out. But at this point, let's get down to business. Now, the man who carries the results is none other than Stephen from Media Edge GSM. And so I'm going to invite him to join us. Hello, Stephen.
Yeah.
So thank you so much. You can tell me for a fact that these are the final results.
Yeah.
Of the final 10 delegates that have made it.
Yeah.
All right, thank you very much. Okay, so there we have it. 10 cards, and on each card is the name of the delegate who has made it into the top 10. Before I go ahead and mention, let me quickly say that throughout the competition, we've been awarding delegates for coming out tops during the various tasks. Today, however, regardless of whether you want a task or not, everybody is up for eviction. And so I'm going to be announcing the winners of the task much later. And what is going to save you are your votes. So I hope that your family members voted as much as possible for you. Well, like I said, I have 10 cards. And so if I mention your name, that means you've made it to the top 10. And so you can take your spot by taking one of the seats over there. So all the best to all of you. Here we go. The first lady to make it into the grand finale of Miss Malaika Ghana is, congratulations to you, Habiba. You can take your seat. And maybe you can take your card as well, you know it. Congratulations to you, Habiba. The next person I'm going to call is The lady who always changes her wigs, and I keep asking her, are you the same person? Finba, congratulations to you. You also have made it to the top 10. Next name is, well, she won the first task for the season, Miss Fitness Kimberly. Congratulations. Here's your ticket. And the next one, are we going to see another medical student probably becoming Miss Malaika Ghana? Sophie, congratulations.
Thank you.
You can take your seat. All right, well, this time around, I'm going to make it easy for you. I stressed you the first time, and so go ahead and smile because this is your ticket to the top 10, Phyllis. Congratulations. Okay, 9 more ladies standing. Who takes the 6th spot? Well, guess what? She was announced as a wild card during the finishing school. And well, she has her ticket to the grand finale. And so congratulations on board. You can take your seat. 6 spots taken, 4 more to go. Before I mention the next set of names, Essie's looking at me like, Bella, you better mention my name. Essie, what's happening to you? What's going on in your mind? You're nervous? All right, let's see how it goes. Let me go over to the other lady who has your hairstyle. Kezia, are you twinning tonight? Kezia can't even smile from her heart. You can see that her face is heavy. Kezia, how are you doing?
I'm nervous.
You're nervous as well?
Yeah.
It's understandable. Let me come to Hamdia. This season in particular, we've received a lot of compliments for the fact that we have given Muslim ladies who wear scarves the opportunity to also take part in the competition. Before you decided to take part, did you think that there was even a slight chance of you making it?
It was two things. It was 50-50. I was thinking maybe they'll take me for some potentials that I have, or...
So it was 50-50?
Yeah, it was 50-50 for
me. But have you enjoyed the season?
Yes, I've learned a lot and I'm still learning and I'm hoping to, you know.
Okay.
Join my colleagues there too.
You're hoping. Okay, I believe everyone is hoping as well. Let me not ask more questions because the way some of you are looking at me, if I ask, I will be in trouble. All the best, ladies. So next name I'm going to call, congratulations to you, Hamdia. Your ticket to the finale. The next name I will be calling is, congratulations to you, Alma. You can smile now.
Thank you.
You are avoiding my gaze. 2 more. Let me make this easy for the next lady before I announce the final. Essie, you can breathe now.
Thank you.
Okay, so there's one more person whose name will be mentioned, and that rounds up our figure for the 2nd of November at the National Theatre. Again, let me remind you that tickets are selling for 100 Ghana cedis. And when you buy your tickets, remember to still continue to vote for your favorite because it goes a long way to help push that person to the top. All right. The final delegate joining our 9 delegates is... Congratulations to you. Well, there she is. And so, Juliet, lucky you, and congratulations. You can take your seat. And that means that as it stands, our 4 delegates, unfortunately, are bowing out.
It's been a long day without you, my friend.
And the truth is that you are to blame for not helping them make it to the grand finale because you did not vote enough. In actual fact, as our delegates are preparing for the finals of Miss Malaika Ghana, you out there also need to vote because as of today and from today till the grand finale, the lady with the highest votes automatically makes it into the top 5. So all the best to you, but also remember that it comes with a lot of hard work. And so make sure that you support your delegate as much as possible and you help her prepare mentally, emotionally, physically for the grand finale, which by the way is happening again at the National Theatre on Saturday, the 2nd of November 2019. And performing on the night, we have Medical Dope Nation, we have Adina And of course, we have Kelvin Boy as well. Tickets are selling fast, and so please grab yours. It's going for 100 Ghana. So our top 10 delegates, thank you so much. And yes, it's still Miss Malaika Ghana 2019.
I'm gonna stand by you.
Enemies see them no be God, them won't see my downfall. But the boy them know the flop. Me across my hands I chuckle. Zanku, 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 Zanku. Enemies won't try figure my steps. Even as I walk through the valley of death. Time no day from a Casio boy. Me.
Join us at the National Theatre on the 2nd of November. Tickets are going for 100 Ghana cedis. See you there.
Some people believe this generation is self-obsessed because of our love for selfies and how we take pictures of everything. But we know better. We know that a selfie is how you capture and celebrate your journey. If you come across something exciting, take a second to capture it. Record it. Show the world. And you never know. It might just be the beginning of something great. That's why we have made the Infinix S4. Infinix S4 with a 32 megapixel AI selfie camera. Empower the Infinity U.
Africa, it's amazing and it's ours. So why not get out there and explore it with Kenya Airways? We crisscross this incredible continent over 500 times a week, offering unrivaled connections to over 40 destinations via our world-class hub in Nairobi. There's so much more to see. Discover Africa with Kenya Airways, the pride of Africa.
What do you look out for when checking into a hotel? Cleanliness, amenities, food, safety, and more. Turmeric Hotel has it all covered. From our luxurious rooms to our fine dining restaurants, swimming pool, fitness center, business center, conference, and more. At Turmeric Hotel, we understand hospitality and we go the whole nine yards. Call reservations today on 0302-510-307, 302-510-382 or info@turmerichotel.com. Locate us at Shiashi Lagos Avenue in East Lagoon. Call us today. We welcome you to an amazing experience. Turmeric Hotel, hospitality redefined.
It's time.
Yes, it's time for the biggest gathering of beautiful women, brains, glitz, glam, style, and the very best of entertainment. The grand finale of Miss Malaika Ghana 2019. Who wins the special 17th edition of Ghana's most respected and most rewarding beauty pageant? Saturday, 2nd November at the National Theatre. Performing live, AMG Medical, Adina, Kelvin Boy, Dope Nation, and more. Get your tickets on www.ticketprogh.com or at Charterhouse, X-Men and Nalem branches at the malls for only 100 Ghana cedis. Supported by Infinix Mobility, Kenya Airways, Dark and Lovely, Copan Hospitality, GTP, Turmeric Hotel, Nasco, Jumia Foods, Maybelline and GH1 TV.
Thanks to our trending team, Ronnie is everywhere. Ameyal Deborah, Ikonkonsa.com, G
GH Kweku, Famebag, Ghana Web, Paul's Ghana, Amazing Memorable Photography by Chocolate Shot It, Lovely Accessories by YS Dazzle, Catwalk and Choreography by Exotic Modeling Agency.
Our props, courtesy Prop Haven inside the trade fair. Grooming by Image Bureau.
Eviction, and unfortunately we have to say goodbye to four of the delegates. And thanks to Copan Hospitality, they are here to cheer us up, and we are here at the Cape Coast Castle to learn more about our ancestors. And after that, we are going to the Kakum National Park, which I've never been there. So come join us, let's have fun, and I can't wait to try the canopy walk. Let's go.
Hello, hello ladies. You all are warmly welcome to Cape Coast Castle.
Thank you.
Okay, my name is Sebastian Kwame Natete, and I'm actually going to take you all on a tour of Cape Coast Castle. So the tour is actually going to start with the male slave dungeons. From the male slave dungeons, we'll proceed to walk on top of an underground tunnel that connects the dungeon to the Door of No Return. We'll talk about the female punishment cell, female dungeon, Door of No Return itself, and then I'll take you to a place called Condemned Cell. After the condemned cell, we will have to see where the white folks lived. So we'll go and see that side, and then we are going to bring the tour to an end. It's going to be a fun-filled tour. This is not fun, but then I'll make sure I lighten the weight for you all. So let's go through this. All right.
Who come to the castle saying, this is the reason why I don't go to church, and a whole lot of other stuff. Yes, it's insane what went on, but tell you what, human beings will always hide behind religion and do very bad stuff in the name of the religion. Is it the doing of the religion or it's the doing of people? It always goes down to people. That is why I tell anybody that comes around that if you belong to a certain spiritual body, it's always about your heart, how you feel about it, and what you do with it as a person. This room was designed for men who were seen to be much stronger and much more aggressive. They will always fight. So they will put them here and lock them up, separate them from the others. The last room was for the youngest of the male captive. The normal men will be in the three rooms in the middle. Well, that was the only source of light and air. So if I turn off the light right now, it's going to go dark in here. This is it. And they'll be staying in it like this. So all the time, this messed up their sight when they were taken out. All right, let's continue. This is the third room of the male dungeon. And everything we are standing on, as I mentioned earlier, is actually made of feces, urine, and so many things with sand covering it up. That is what we are standing on. This is what I call the DNA of the Africans that were made to stay here some years ago. But at the very top, you see that hole. That hole you see happens to be at the very entrance of the first Church of England built in the whole of West Africa. Whenever the Europeans worshipped at the top, the noise from there came down. That was to sensitize the people that were here. Even though, yes, they don't understand whatever the Europeans are saying out there, but it gives them the impression that they are happy worshipping their God at the top, whereas the people here were belonging to African traditional religion or Islamic religion. And if you are here belonging to that religion, you are sleeping beside your piss and poop, dying of thirst and starvation, going through all kinds of struggle. If that is the case, what are they trying to tell you? Your religion is bad. So just forget about your religion and follow theirs. Because when they take them out there, they are converting them. So that was used to work on them psychologically. Let's go into the last room.
Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our mind.
Today is my third time here.
Really?
Today is my second time. And trust me, the first time I came, I didn't listen to anything the tour guide said. But today, I got to listen to every bit of it. And trust me, I don't even know how to feel about it.
Same here. Listening to the tour guide tell us the story behind the slave trade was really, really sorrowful. Looking at how our ancestors struggled and all of that is really, really sad.
The last room has got more light than the other rooms we've seen with light bulbs, obviously. It's because the exit for the men was here. But before we talk about the exit, the shrine you see here is an active shrine, Nana Tabir Shrine. It's believed by the indigenous that, you know, this gives the fisher folks bumper harvest and it gives the women children. But you know, this wasn't here during the slave trade. It was taken out of here into the town by the chiefs that gave this land out. But around 1960, Ghana became republic after independence in 1957. The chiefs had come to realize the Europeans have left entirely. They will never return here, not to talk of this place. So they decided to come. They built this altar, brought the pieces of stones they took off of the huge Rocky Mountain outside into the town. And these are the very original stones, but it hasn't got the original color. It's covered in blood. And the blood is not that of humans, but that of animals they sacrifice here all of the time. At the back of this dome, we have this thick wall. This wall has never been a part of the original building. Then it means there is something hidden behind it. That happens to be the entrance of the underground tunnel that connected the male dungeon and the door of no return about 70 meters. So all the men that were made to stay here whenever the ships came, they were shackled and chained to each other and were forced to go through the tunnel. Late in the night when the whole town is very quiet and asleep, and at that time, as they walked through, the heat trapped in there, the heat their bodies generated, made it hot on the inside. But it was late in the night. It's dark. You can't see your way through the tunnel. Even if it's daytime, you can't see your way through. So they used lanterns, which has got fire, which gave them the light. But fire, on the other hand, generated heat. So it will make it much hotter. And when people are walking through tunnels, getting oxygen to breathe in is very cumbersome or very difficult. So you go through it, you end up at the door of no return. You don't have the energy to fight and free yourself. Knowing very well that when you leave through the door of no return, that is your moment of truth as an African, leaving the continent and never returning to it. And if you look on the other side, there are lots of wreaths made of plastic ribbons brought in here by Africans from the diaspora. They always come here and lay wreaths just to pay their respect to their ancestors.
But sometimes some European sympathizers will just walk in and lay wreath as well to also pay their respect. That's why you see them all over. Yeah.
You spoke about the strong men going in first before the sick ones. Were there cases where both the strong and sick couldn't make it to the end of the tunnel because of the congestion and heat? So meaning like they died in there.
Well, the thing is, always the people that were fit and strong made it. It was only the sick and the weak people that most of the times were never sent through the tunnel. Because after all, no matter what happens, they will not make it. That is more like a waste. So they will let them stay back, all the strong people will leave, and then they will always take them out there and care for them. Yes.
I would like to know where the slaves were mostly brought from, and then how were they communicating with each other and their masters also?
Okay, so they were brought from different tribes. At that time, tribes around here, they spoke different languages. So sometimes if a person is speaking Ga, I don't understand Ga. So we don't know each other like that. We don't talk. We'd rather even be fighting for space in the dungeons as to who is to sit and who is to stand and all of that stuff. And they'll bring in people from Nigeria, Mali, Senegal, Benin, Burkina Faso, Togo, Ivory Coast, so many places. They will walk all the way down here. And language barrier was always a problem. So the Europeans were rather training people around here who were doing that job, communicating with the people and sometimes communicating with them. Yeah. Okay.
Songs of freedom.
Till morning, I just want your loving. Oh, I want, you for show me something better. I don't want your money, I just want your loving. Oh, I want, you for show me something where I don't see before.
On the 2nd of November. Tickets are going for 100 Ghana cedis. See you there!
Infinix S4.
Family is. We're all the same, yet different in our tastes. That is why we have a drink for everyone. Whether it's for the easy-go-lucky ones or for the not-so-easy ones. The urban swags or for the deep-rooted. For the ones who shine during the day or for the ones who sparkle at night. For the bubbly ones, or for the one who is cool as ice cold water. For the ones who love to flex, or for the active ones. For the young ones, or for the young at heart. Whatever be the difference, we are Ghanaians, and we are one big fun-loving family. Fun beverages for Ghana, by Ghana. Beverages from Bell Family. Proudly Ghanaian. This advertisement has been vetted and approved by the FDA.
Delegate stylish designs and clothing by African by Nana, Sherry Brown Couture, Nippo Skin, Sante Trends, Ajua Yeboah Clothing, Lamle Couture,
Kweku Ejenin Boating,
Gifty Glisa Ata, September by Awulana, Annie's Bespoke, Akuchi, Etruba Couture, Bull and Wood Merchandise, Everything Girly Boutique, number one fan clothing.
Oh, freedom.
All right, so ladies, let's take it that all of you here will be the very strong African women that will always never allow the Europeans to abuse you sexually. You will always try to escape from the castle. They will bring you here for about a week maximum. And the women that stayed here were about 6 women maximum. You get food and water once a day. You get food and water once a day through that hole, which was their source of light and air. You will defecate and urinate in the hole right here. And this was locked up with a very heavy door like the one you saw on the condemned cell for the men. Sometimes people will end up here a week. They'll go back to the dungeon and stay there for a week or more before a ship will arrive for them. Sometimes too, you find yourself here, the next day there is a ship, you will leave. People came here and lost their lives. They were thrown into the sea. We are in the female dungeon, and we have 2 separate dungeons for the women. This one and the one on the opposite side. Each room holding about 250 people. If I say people, it means it's not only women that were here. There were kids, both male and female, amidst the women. From the ages of 10 to about 13 years. All mixed up. Here in the dungeons of the castle, as I mentioned earlier, they never took a single shower. Because they've already had their last bath at Asinmasu slave market. You walk from there to here. You are filthy already. But it says last bath, no shower. But tell you what, the Europeans will constantly frequent the female dungeons, picking women up, abusing them sexually. So much so that sometimes they'll find some of the women showing signs of pregnancy in the dungeon. They had houses out of the castle where they care for them. Do you have your baby? The baby will be groomed. They grow up becoming interpreters, clerks, secretaries, and all of that, bridging the gap between the local African community and the European communities. And these kids were the kids that were named Johnson, Yorson, Blankson, Wilson, Wilberforce, Kilson, and all the sins. But then I'll tell you for a fact, some of the women that walked out there, they never came back here because the Europeans liked them as women after having their kids. Some, majority, found themselves back here. They will bring them back here, they will ship them abroad. But you know, any woman that was found pregnant aboard a ship was bound to die. Pregnancy comes with complications, morning sickness and everything. The people were packed on decks, one on top of the other, just like books on shelves. You will find yourself at the bottom of a deck. There is someone at the top that will defecate and urinate. Think about it, diarrhea, seasickness, and all kinds of stuff. Women in every month will menstruate since it took them about 3 months. All that waste will not stay at the top. It will drop from the top to the bottom. It took them 6 weeks or 3 months. You do the math. That is why by the time the ships made it out there, about 40% of the people will be dead. Out of 100%. But whether people died or survived, all in the name of insurance, the Europeans still made money. And here, they were not buying Africans with money, but out there, people paid hundreds and thousands of dollars to buy African men and women. Because of that, the transatlantic slave trade, amongst all trades, is said to be one of the most profitable business that ever existed on the surface of the earth. People that participated in it, still today, their children are enjoying from that wealth. Well, ladies and gentlemen, let's continue, talk about the door of no return, and then we'll bring the tour to an end. So ladies, whoever walked out of the door of no return never ever went back in. You walk out of the door forcefully. You walk down the stairs right here. The soil down there becomes the last African soil they ever touch in Africa. Because the boats were right here on the shore. You're going to get on the boat. It will take you to the ship about a mile away. The ship will leave Africa entirely. Anybody that came out lost their name, their family, their dignity, property,
everything was taken away from them. You go out there to the new world and start life all over again from scratch. But at the back of the door of no return, we have door of return there, which allows us to go back to the castle. Why is it door of return now? It became door of return when Africans that were taken away at some point decided to go to Africa and celebrate their freedom in Africa. Organizing a trip from several parts of the world, going back to Ghana to celebrate Emancipation Day, which was themed the Great Homecoming. They came to Cape Coast Castle via the ocean all the way down to this port. At the port, they carry the caskets, walk them up the stairs they used down and never used it back up, through the door they used out and never went back in, to the courtyard of Cape Coast Castle, where they had an amazing ceremony, breaking the jinx of door of no return to door of return. Meaning everybody that was taken away, even if all of them are dead today, their kids can go back to the castle, find their roots or wherever they were taken from. That's why we have door of return there and Akwaaba on the wall if you had seen it. So the Akwaaba is there to welcome all of us back in there. As we are going back, this is what I'm going to say. Slavery still exists. It's going on in so many different forms, and as people, when we see it go on, the best we do most of the times is keeping quiet, walking away, and enjoying our peace of mind. But please, I don't want you to do this. When you go out there and you see forms of it, don't turn a blind eye. Do something about it. Change someone's life today. They will change another person's life tomorrow. Well, I don't know what you all are here doing, but I'll say good luck. Good luck on your pageant as well. I wish you all win at the same time. And once again, my name has been Sebastian Kwame Natete. It's been a pleasure having you in Cape Coast Castle. Have a blast. Thank you all. One day.
We are done with the castle tour. It's been very sad and enlightening. But thankfully, we don't end the day on a sad note. We get to visit Kakum National Park. And me, personally, I'm very scared to walk on the canopy. So I don't know how I'm going to do it.
I'm not scared. I'll be there to experience it.
So I'm going to give it a try.
Thank you to Copan Hospitality for making this possible. We get to tour the whole of Cape Coast and have a fun day. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Glory. What? Your back like blackish. Go. Put a waist on rotation. Gaga. On points like punctuation. Baby, you deserve a standing ovation. No matter.
Although I ego. Baby, I never see your type. My girl, I like your vibe. For your love in a good time. Baby, I ego.
Join us at the National Theatre on the 2nd of November. Tickets are going for 100 Ghana cedis. See you there!
At dawn,
after the wedding bell ceased,
all newly wedded couples
yearn for a memorable honeymoon.
Do you want a honeymoon full of
fun,
relaxation,
silliness,
sports and wellness,
love,
or
adventure
for the ultimate honeymoon destination?
Visit the Holy Trinity Spa and Health Farm,
Sogakope,
1 hour drive
from Accra,
Tema.
It's incredible! Bang on target!
Nasco, bring home happiness.
Our ladies glammed up by
Black Cherry Beauty Lounge, Adele's Makeover, FABMUA, Belle Flair, Faces by Kes, D-Lin Hair, Mercy Lumo Artistry, Cook's Hair, Pretty with Oyinka, Nail Garden.
Thank you, NASCO, for this wonderful gift. I urge all viewers to keep voting for their favorite contestants.
Hi, I'm Larry, and I want to thank NASCO for this wonderful present they've given me. I voted for Fimba, so keep your votes coming. Thank you.
I just want myself a NASCO blender for answering correctly to the Miss Malaika pageant questions. So do same and win yourself something.
Ago!
Amen!
Ago!
Amen!
Once again, you are welcome to Kakum Conservation Area. Kakum actually begins from here. So, where I'm standing, I hope you can see me. You have the boundary? I hope you can see. That's the boundary of the national park. So, it's all start from here. Kakum is a conservation area because it is made up of two forest reserves. We have the Asin Atendensu Forest Reserve. We have Kakum Forest Reserve. Because they are close, they join the two. And the area is known as Kakum Conservation Area. But the popular name out there is Kakum National Park. The park was given to us by nature. By virtue of Ghana's position on Earth, we came to meet this park. But it was the British who started with the conservation of this area. Because they were cutting trees left, right, and center. So the trees were getting out of hand. So they decided that they will enact law that will protect the trees over here. So in 1907, they decided to enact the first conservation law. And the law was that no one should cut any young tree. That was the law. So when Ghana became independent, we also decided to continue. That's how come we have this forest still over here. Yeah? And at the moment, it's a protected area. In 1992, Ghana legally gazetted this area as a national park. The walkway was originally opened to the general public on 29th April 1995. And Rawlings came here to do the honors by officially opening the canopy walkway to the general public. After two Canadians, Tom and John, with some assistance from six Ghanaians, so they were eight in number, took 6 months to build the walkway. So they use materials like nylon ropes, we have nets, we have wooden board, we have ladder, and we have steel rod that's on top of the tree. So the walkway is very safe, one of the safest in the world, thanks to the durable timber they use for the walkway. The bridges are eight in number, eight. Originally they did only seven, but because people were complaining about height issues, we decided to add an eighth bridge, which serves as a bypass. So after the first bridge, if you can continue, you turn your left and use the bypass, that's the shorter one. If you are very brave like myself, you turn right and you are going to walk across. Yeah, you are going to walk across seven of the bridges. On the bridge, it wobbles and it creaks. So forget about the noise. Eh? Just continue walking. Yeah. Creaking. Yeah. Yes. After each. Oh, it's not going to tear. After each, no, I'm going to tell you. After each bridge, we have a platform. So there that you stand to look at the forest, take a lot of photographs, then you continue. So if you don't have questions, let us get inside the primary forest, do the canopy walkway and continue.
Let's go. Hey.
So the canopy walkway experience all starts from here. You are going to take the first step here. This is the first bridge, the first of eight. So after this, you decide left or right. Left for short, right for long.
So ladies, we are finally at Kakum National Park and we have the option of choosing the long way or the short way. Which one do you prefer?
Long way!
Okay, then you are going long.
Yes. Let's do this! Yes, girls!
Was very fun and interactive and also educative, and Habiba really cracked us up. She made it really fun. Yes, she was crying the whole time. I wasn't expecting it because Habiba looks like someone who is a very strong girl.
Yes.
And then also our producer was very scared, so she insisted we do the three
short
walks
one,
instead of the eight walk. Yes.
But it was fun. I wanted to do it again. It was really, really
fun. I really wanted to go for the eight walk. I've done this before and I think the second time I wasn't really scared as the first time.
Yeah.
So yeah, it was fun.
I've also been here, but I was young. I was really scared, but I think this was okay and it was fun.
Thank you, Copan Hospitality, for this wonderful experience. We love you.
With over 300 ladies.
Yes, and being a part of the top 10 delegates brought us so much joy.
It has been a long journey with high and low moments.
Oh yes, and we have learned a lot as a family.
But for now, it's crunch time for all 10 of us. Wow, how time flies.
I know, right? Come join us on the final night for the glitz and glamour.
The Miss Malaika finale will be happening on the 2nd of November 2019
at the National Theatre at 8 p.m.
Performing live are Adina, Medical, Kelvin Boy and Dope Nation.
Tickets are selling at Charterhouse, X-Men and all Nalem stores at the mall at only 100 Ghana cedis.
Supported by Infinix Mobility, Kenya Airways, Dark and Lovely, Copan Hospitality, GTP, Tomwick Hotel, NASCO, Jumia Foods, Maybelline, and GH1 TV. Zanku.